War fears as Iranian terrorists claim to have resistance cells planted in Washington. War fears have surged after Iranian militia groups claim to have active resistance cells stationed in Washington and other U.S. cities. Posts in the online forum Kawtheryoon Electronic Team, used by Iranian militia groups and their supporters, claim that Iranian resistance cells are rooted even in America and its capital, according to the Middle East Media Research Institute. The post online also claimed that terror factions linked with Iran are attracting more support and becoming stronger. They also called on the U.S. to withdraw all of its troops from Iraq and the Middle East. According to the Middle East Media Research Institute, the post also included a picture depicting caskets of U.S. soldiers and a resistance fighter watching over rockets being launched over a city. Resistance cells are rooted even in America and its capital. It comes as U.S. President Joe Biden refused to offer upfront sanctions relief to Iran. Mr. Biden is seeking to revive and broaden the 2015 agreement which limited Iran's nuclear program, which Donald Trump previously abandoned. President Biden hopes to put greater limits on Iran's nuclear program, its missile development, and constrain its regional activities. The U.S. State Department has called on Iran to cease its terror operations. But Tehran has shown no signs of ending its operations in Yemen, Syria, Lebanon, and other Middle Eastern areas. Iran has continued to support strikes on U.S. personnel stationed in Iraq. Washington launched its own air strikes on Iran-backed fighters in Syria last month in response to a rocket attack on a base hosting U.S. troops in Erbil, Iraq, on February 15. U.S. defense officials told Reuters that Mr. Biden had approved the most limited option for an attack. According to Reuters, Clement Thurm, an Iran expert at the European University Institute, said Mr. Biden avoided prompting domestic opposition, but that it could not last forever. He said, "They are deft in the sense that they aren't going to extinguish their political capital just after the elections to extend a hand to an Iranian government that's been despised in the U.S. for the last 30 years." During his time at the White House, Mr. Trump criticized the nuclear agreement for failing to rein in Iran's support for proxy forces. The former president reimposed U.S. sanctions on Iran after withdrawing from the PACs in 2018.